गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू हैव सीन आवर लास्ट वीडियो दैट इज ऑन परचेज बुक, इन विच वी हैव एन इलस्ट्रेशन और ऑन परचेज बुक इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ टू पोस्ट एंट्रीज इन परचेज बुक एंड हाउ टू डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन गुड्स एंड परचेज ऑफ एसेट. सो इन केस ऑफ परचेज बुक वी वर रिकॉर्डिंग ओनली क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन इन टू द परचेज बुक. एंड क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन इज ओनली फॉर दोज गुड्स इन विच वी आर ट्रेडिंग, आइदर परचेजिंग और सेलिंग. बट इन केस ऑफ परचेज ऑफ एन एसेट वी आर नॉट पोस्टिंग इन टू द परचेज बुक. फॉर परचेज ऑफ एनी एसेट वी हैव एन सेपरेट बुक, दैट इज अवर जर्नल प्रॉपर बुक. ऑन द सेम थीम, वैन वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स एंड ऑन क्रेडिट बेसिस, वी हैव टू पोस्ट एंट्री इन द सेल्स बुक, बिकॉज इन कैश बुक वी ओनली पोस्ट द कैश ट्रांजेक्शन्स और कैश सेल्स. बट फॉर क्रेडिट सेल्स वी नीड एन अदर सेपरेट बुक, दैट वी हैव सेल्स बुक. इन सेल्स बुक वी पोस्ट एंट्रीज ओनली फॉर क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ गुड्स, नॉट अ क्रेडिट सेल ऑफ एसेट्स और नॉट अ कैश सेल्स. बट वी पोस्ट ओनली क्रेडिट सेल्स, दैट इज ऑल्सो दैट गुड्स इन विच वी आर ट्रेडिंग. सी, सेल्स बुक इज अ जर्नल, इज ए स्पेशल जर्नल इन विच क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ गुड्स बाय द फर्म आर रिकॉर्डेड. एज आई टोल्ड, सेल्स बुक इज फॉर द क्रेडिट सेल ट्रांजेक्शन. कैश सेल्स आर रिकॉर्डेड इन द कैश बुक. येस, वी नो वी ऑलरेडी हैव डन अवर कैश बुक, इन विच वी रिकॉर्ड ऑल द कैश सेल्स एंड कैश परचेजेस, नॉट इन द सेल्स बुक. ऑल्सो क्रेडिट सेल ऑफ द आइटम अदर देन द गुड्स बाय फर्म. एज आई टोल्ड, अदर देन द गुड्स बाय फर्म, गुड्स इन विच फर्म इज ट्रेडिंग, नॉट दोज गुड दैट फर्म इज परचेजिंग फॉर देयर ऑफिस यूज और एनीथिंग लाइक एसेट्स. इफ आई एम एन ए ट्रेडर ऑफ गारमेंट एंड आई एम सेलिंग और परचेजिंग बुक्स, स्टेशनरीज, सो दीज आर द एसेट्स फॉर मी, नॉट गुड फॉर मी, बिकॉज आई एम ट्रेडिंग इन गारमेंट. सो इफ आई एम परचेजिंग पेंट एंड शर्ट्स, देन इट विल बी एन गुड फॉर मी, बट अदर थिंग दैट आई एम परचेजिंग एंड सेलिंग, दैट इज नॉट गुड्स फॉर मी. सो गुड्स ओनली आर दोज इन विच फर्म इज ट्रेडिंग. लाइक इन सेल्स बुक वी ऑल्सो रिकॉर्ड ओनली क्रेडिट सेल ऑफ दोज गुड्स इन विच वी ट्रेड. अदर गुड्स आर वी रिकॉर्ड इन टू द जर्नल प्रॉपर बुक. एग्जाम्पल, सेल ऑफ एसेट्स आर नॉट रिकॉर्डेड इन टू द सेल बुक, दे आर रिकॉर्डेड इन टू द जर्नल प्रॉपर. एंट्रीज इन द सेल्स बुक आर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ इनवॉइस इश्यूड टू द कस्टमर विद द नेट अमाउंट आफ्टर ट्रेड डिस्काउंट. एज वी सीन एंट्रीज इन द परचेज बुक, दैट आफ्टर द टोटल ऑफ ग्रोस अमाउंट वॉट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू डू सब्ट्रैक्ट ट्रेड डिस्काउंट फ्रॉम इट, और आइदर इफ वी पेड एनी फ्रेट ऑन इट, वी नीड टू एड फ्रेट इन द आवर टोटल कॉस्ट. सो वी नीड टू पुट नेट अमाउंट इन अवर सेल्स बुक, नॉट द ग्रोस अमाउंट. फॉर ग्रोस अमाउंट वी आर नॉट पोस्टिंग, बिकॉज ग्रोस अमाउंट वी आर नॉट पेइंग. इफ द ग्रोस अमाउंट ऑफ सेल इज 10,000 एंड वी गॉट अ डिस्काउंट ऑफ 1,000, देन द ट्रांजेक्शन देन द क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन लाइज इन अवर बुक इज ओनली ऑफ 9,000, नॉट 10,000. नाउ वी डू नॉट हैव टू पे 10,000, सो वी विल रिकॉर्ड इट बाय 9,000. एंड एक्स्ट्रा इफ वी आर पेइंग फ्रेट और एनीथिंग ऑन दैट, वी नीड टू रिकॉर्ड दैट ऑल्सो इन अवर सेल्स बुक. सो फ्यू आर द फीचर्स ऑफ द सेल्स बुक. फर्स्ट इज क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ गुड्स आर रिकॉर्डेड इन टू द सेल बुक. सेकेंड इज क्रेडिट सेल्स ऑफ आइटम अदर देन गुड्स बाय द फर्म आर नॉट रिकॉर्डेड इन द सेल्स बुक. एज आई टोल्ड, एनी आइटम दैट इज नॉट अ गुड्स फॉर अ फर्म, दैट वी विल नॉट रिकॉर्ड इन टू द सेल्स बुक. इफ वी आर सेलिंग अदर आइटम्स, लाइक इफ आई एम एन ट्रेडर ऑफ स्टेशनरी एंड आई एम सेलिंग सम इलेक्ट्रिकल इक्विपमेंट, देन इट इज एन एसेट सेलिंग फॉर मी, दैट आई विल रिकॉर्ड इन टू द जर्नल प्रॉपर, नॉट इन टू द सेल्स बुक. इन सेल्स बुक आई विल रिकॉर्ड ओनली दोज ट्रांजेक्शन इन विच आई एम डीलिंग ऑन डे टू डे और ऑन वीकली बेसिस. अवर नेक्स्ट ट्रांजेक्शन, नेक्स्ट फीचर इज कैश सेल्स आर नॉट रिकॉर्डेड इन द सेल्स बुक, सिंस दीज आर रिकॉर्डेड इन टू द कैश बुक. एज आई टोल्ड, कैश सेल इज अ पार्ट ऑफ कैश बुक, नॉट अ सेल्स बुक. सो सेल्स बुक, इन सेल्स बुक वी रिकॉर्ड ओनली द क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन. फॉर कैश ट्रांजेक्शन वी हैव सेपरेट बुक, दैट इज कैश बुक, एज वी स्टडी इन अर्लियर क्लासेस. Entries are recorded on basis of invoice. As I told, we record it's based on invoice. Sales book, this is the format for the sales book, same as the purchase book. It is also have date, particular invoice, ledger folio, details, sales value, freight and total. In sales book, in case of sales book also we follow only after ledger folio, that is detail, and that after this one total amount. These are the column if we have any transaction about freight and cartage in our whole transaction, then we will make this column also and this column also. If we do not have, then we do not need to make this column if we do not paid freight on any cartage. So we will have an question on sale book, then we will know that how to post entries into the sales book, how to differentiate between the cash and credit transactions, and how to differentiate between goods and assets also. Okay, this is the question for sales book that we are going to solve. As I told, we do not need to put another column, that is freight and cartage, if we do not have that into our question. So in this question we do not have any freight or cartage, so I am not making another column, that is freight and cartage. So the question is, Mr. Kishore and Sons from Delhi selling ready-made garments. It means Mr. Kishore and Son is a dealer or trader of ready-made garments. So every type of garment that they are going to sell, that we will count into the sales book. Other things if they are selling, we will not post into our sales book. So first entry for them, that they sold goods to Mr. Gupta and Verma into Delhi, 30 shirts at the rate 400 each and 20 trousers at the rate 600 each, less trade discount 10%. So it means they sold goods to Mr. Gupta, that is 30 shirts and 20 trousers. As we know, the both are garments, so these are the goods for the Kishore and Sons, and they also allowed a discount, that is 10%. Okay, so we will post this entry because they are trading into the garments. So first, as I told, we need to put the name whom we are selling, that is MS Gupta and Verma. What we sold, 30 shirts at the rate 400 each, 20 trousers at the rate 600 each. So this is our total unit that we sold, that is 30 and 20 trousers, and the cost of per unit is 400 and 600 for trousers. So the total amount will be 12,000. So gross amount is 24,000. So Mr. Kishore and Sons sold a gross amount of 24,000 garments to the Mr. Gupta. So what we need to do now, we have another transaction, that is they are receiving discount. So we need to deduct discount from the gross amount, as we have discussed into the purchase book also, that after the gross amount we need to check if there is any trade discount or freight in the question. In this question we have trade discount, so we need to deduct trade discount, less trade discount at the rate 10%, that is 2400. In outer column we will post 21,600. So this is the amount that Mr. Gupta need to pay to Mr. Kishore. So Mr. Kishore sold goods of the amount of 21,600 to Mr. Gupta. It is a credit transaction and it is the transaction of selling of goods, not for assets. So we will post entry into the sales book. Now we need to close this entry because we have only a single entry for Mr. Gupta and Verma. Then we will move our next entry, that is sold old furniture to Mr. Sehgal and Company Delhi for 8,000. As I told, we need to first separate selling of goods and selling of assets. And because Mr. Kishore is a trader of garments, not a trader of furniture, so if he is selling any furniture, any car, any bike, it is not his business. So we will not record it this transaction into our sales book because it is not a deal into the goods that in which the firm is dealing. Firm is dealing in garment, but this is a sale for asset. So for this one and for this entry, we have a separate book that is general proper. All these type of transaction of sold of furniture or anything, we will post into the journal ledger, not into the sales book. In sales book, we will post on only those in for sales for those good in which the firm is trading, and firm is trading now into the garments. Next entry is sold 50 shirts. Yes, this is good for Mr. Kishore and company because they are a trader of garments. So they sold 50 shirts to Mr. Jain and Sons Kanpur at the rate 400 each. First, we need to put the name whom they are selling, that is MS Jain and Sons Kanpur. What they sold to them? They sold 50 shirts at the rate 400 per unit. So the total gross amount will be 5420. And we do not have trade discount, so we will post the amount directly into the outer column. Because in this entry, we do not have to deduct any type of discount or we do not have to add any type of freight in this. So we will not post in detail option. We will go outer column, that is amount column directly. So we need to close this entry because we have done with this entry. So till now we have two transactions. Mr. Kishore have two transactions. That is one, first one with Mr. Gupta, second one with Mr. Sehgal, and third one with Mr. Jain. But the transaction he have with Mr. Sehgal, that we will not record into the sales book because it is a transaction of selling of asset, and sales book is only for selling of goods, not for selling of assets. Another entry they have, that is sold to Mr. Mathur and Jain Kolkata. So they are selling to Mr. Mathur what they are selling 100 shirts at the rate 100 per unit and 10 overcoat at the rate 1000 per unit. But in this question, in this transaction, we also have trade discount, so we will post the total gross amount in internal column because we have to deduct trade discount also from the gross amount. So the total will be 1400 shirt. This is 400 per each. Actually, it is 400. 40,000, then 10 overcoats, 1000 per each, that is 10,000. The gross amount is 50,000 now. Now we need to deduct trade discount from it, less trade discount at the rate 10%. So the 10% of total amount is 5,000. And the net amount we need to post in outer column, that is 45,000. So this is how we post entries into the sales book. Two things that we need to clear. First is separate between goods and assets. Second thing, separate between cash transaction and credit transaction. In this question, we do not get any cash transaction also. If there is a cash transaction or cash sale, then we will not record that into this book because this book is only for recording of credit transaction. And another thing is sale of goods or sale of asset. If they are selling the asset, then we will also not record it into the sales book. So now we need to close our purchase book and transfer sales book and transfer this amount to the sales account. First, we need to close this entry. Then we need to close these. Now we need to totalize this one, that is It is 6,600 and need to transfer it into the sales account. Sales account credited. One more thing that in yesterday when we are posted entries into the purchase book, we are using debit here. Now we are using credit here. As we know, sales, we in case of sale, we debit cash and credit sale. In case of purchase, we debit purchase and credit sales, because in case of purchase we are paying, but in case of sale we are receiving. So in when we are receiving, that means we need to debit the amount that we are receiving, not the sale. In case of purchase also, we need to debit the purchase and credit that amount that we are paying. Now this is the question that we have on sales book, in which we have discussed the differentiation between the goods and assets, and the other thing is separation between the cash sale and credit sale. So we have only four transactions, in which we found only a single transaction, that is sale of asset, that we do not post it into the sales book because we have a separate book, that is general proper. Another thing, if we have any freight or packaging charges, how we will post entry in this book? This is then I will add another entry of adding. So now we have another entry in which we have trade discount and freight both simultaneously. So in this entry, Mr. Kishore is selling goods to Mr. Gary and Sons from Delhi. He is selling 20 shirts at the rate 600 per unit. As we know, Mr. Kishore is a dealer of garments and he is selling shirts. So the transaction we will record into the sales book. But the thing is that we need to know that they have any two other information also, that is trade discount. Trade discount, as we know, that we need to deduct from it, but now they added freight and packaging charges, that is 1600. Now as I told in starting of the video, if there is any freight and packaging, then we need to maintain a separate column for that, that is here. Now I am made, that is freight column. How to record it in? First, as we done earlier, we need to put the name of that person, Gary and Sons, what we are selling to him, 20 shirts at the rate 600 per unit. The total cost then will be 12,000. After that, we need to deduct trade discount, that is 5%. That is 600. The gross amount of sale is now 11,400. But this is not the net amount that we need to receive from the Gary and Sons, because they have paid freight and packaging charges also 600. So we will add this into the bill, that is add freight and packaging charges, that we have 1600. We need to add this into this column. As we earlier did, we need to make this one 13,000, and we need to put this amount directly to the outer column, that is the total amount of sale. In this question, we need to maintain another column, that is freight column, and we need to mention the amount of freight in this column, that is 1600. So the process is very simple, as we did in above sales book. In that, we are only selling goods, we are allowing discount also, but we do not have freight or any packaging charging. But in another entry, when the freight and packaging charges is added, we need to add it into the total amount of bill, because it is very simple. When if we are purchasing any equipment, the delivering cost or packaging cost to deliver it to our home or to packaging it for delivering to our home, the cost that we need to bear, not the purchaser or seller. So in this case, they will add the amount of expenses that they expense on the packaging of that product. They will add into the bill, and the purchaser have to pay that amount to the seller. So this is the question on the sales book, in which we have discussed about sales of goods, sales of assets, and sales of goods with freight and packaging charges also. So you need to separate between goods and assets. And another thing, for freight it is very simple, just add it up into the gross amount after deducting the trade discount. First we need to deduct trade discount from our gross amount.